its contenders are not creatures of habit, but creatures of innovation. It's time to recap the first round of the Animal Engineers Division. I am MC Marmot, and this is March Mammal Madness. Arrived in Australia at the base of a cathedral termite mound and found some dingo droppings.
When you gotta go, you gotta go.
The beetle set to work and began rolling the dung ball up the mound. But the mound was too steep. The dung ball rolled back down and the beetle chased it right off the field of battle. Take that, Sisyphus. The termite wins. The Montezuma, or Ependula, weighs 2.36 stokes on average. The New Caledonian Crow is about equally matched at 1.61 stokes. The crow arrived in Costa Rica and began looking for insects. The Montezuma, or Ependula, saw the newcomer and approached. Was this a giant cowbird coming for its eggs? Better safe than sorry. The Orapendula attacked. The crow dodged and then counterattacked. The Orapendula fled, leading the crow to victory. And see, I am back in the past. In 22 million years, this is going to be Nebraska, believe it or not. The trapdoor spider just got here too. So it's digging a burrow right by this hole. The paleocaster just trampled over everything, including the spider. Well, that was quick.
Hey, MC. I'm coming to you from high above the Congo River where we got a lungfish down there in the mud. He's hunting in the mud, sliming around, rolling around, whatever he's doing down there. And it looks like we got our good friend, the tent-making bat. He's up in a tree popping tents. There he is working with the leaves. And this may take a while, kids. He's all by himself. So you might want to go grab some pop. Wait a minute. It looks like a gust of wind has just blown the tent-making bat into the mud. Oh no! And now the lungfish is eating it. This is a travesty.
Hey, MC, I'm still in Scotland, where marshmallow magic has brought the Spongilla fly to the Golden Eagle's turf. And the fly is in big trouble. So first off, it's on the eagle's talon, where you do not want to be. And secondly, it's March, which means the fly is a larva and can only breathe in water. So it's a goner.
Oh,
and
no.
The eagle just ate it without even noticing. Wow. Well, back to you. The red ovenbird was really constructing its nest when it was suddenly March Mammal Magicked to Queensland, Australia. The bird was furious. It has to start rebuilding. Meanwhile, the Kawana emerged from its burrow and started climbing the tree.
Hi there.
The bird was livid and flew off to a more peaceful area. The Kawana wins. The pufferfish found itself on the floor of the Indian Ocean. It began plowing a trench to construct its geometric sand circle. What was this? A walking coconut? The veined octopus strode through the sand. The pufferfish watched in confusion as the octopus continued strolling right off the battlefield. The pufferfish wins this battle of bizarre performance art. Weird.
Hey kids, it's me. I'm Puppet Brad, and I'm coming to you to tell you all about the Homo habilis. That's his Latin baronial name, but I'm not going to call him that because it just makes you snicker and laugh. So I'm going to call him the Handyman. He's just hanging out 1.7 million years ago. And that's a really long time, kid. And he's banging the rocks together. He's making some tools. So this bee shows up, this nosy little bee shows up and says, "Oh my gosh, you're so loud. You're making too much racket. I don't like rock music." And it flies away. And there he is. There's my handyman banging the rocks together. What you making, handyman? We'll find out next time. He wins.
It's back to the drawing board for some, but one step forward for others. We will be back with more Rodent Recaps. Thank you for watching. Laura Pendle, friend, leaving the crow the victor.